All right, moving to our coronavirus coverage tonight. One case in Nevada has been confirmed by the CDC so far.
Authorities say the man in Washoe County who got the coronavirus on the Grand Princess cruise ship has tested positive for coronavirus, COVID-19. Now, there are still three other presumptive positive cases, two in Clark County and one in Washoe County. The I-Team's Vanessa Murphy here live in studio with new information about how the Southern Nevada Health District is handling coronavirus.
And what has not yet been provided to the public?
Well, we are waiting for information, but we have learned more about how the health district is trying to track coronavirus. I'm told a new app was created where people who are under surveillance report their daily symptoms. If an individual fails to log their info, a disease investigator is informed. Now, moving forward, if more screening is needed here in Southern Nevada, stations would be outside the health district to lessen exposure to health workers and the public. And we've reported previously on how Southern Nevada has a significant homeless population. This week, the health district plans on meeting with groups who help the homeless to plan for a possible outbreak. And we've learned there were 49 Nevadans on the cruise ship off California, some of them from Clark County. According to Governor Steve Sisolak's office, as of last night, 21 of the passengers aboard the Grand Princess tested positive for coronavirus. And as of last night, the 49 Nevadans were asymptomatic. We've learned about a possible plan to bring Nevadans home, transport them here on a federally chartered plane. They would then be picked up by a private ambulance at the airport and taken to their homes. Governor Sisolak sent a letter to the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services Monday night about conditions he wants imposed in the transport of the passengers from Nevada. Now, he wants them tested for coronavirus before they board the plane. They would need to be isolated once they are here and under supervision of health officials. And this is a developing story both about these passengers and how the Southern Nevada Health District is handling this.
And Vanessa, information so key with what's going on with coronavirus. Any word from the health district in terms of public information officers?
We requested interviews both yesterday and today. We also asked if there were going to be press conferences.
Okay.
Washoe County held a press conference yesterday and today. The health district here has a public information officer, a public information manager, but so far, no press conference, no interviews.
We will keep asking.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Vanessa.
Thanks.